Welcome back inside Mission Control Houston. That again, a look at Karen Nyberg, her love of running, something she'll be doing quite a bit of while she's in space. Joining me now, another NASA astronaut, Dottie Metcalf-Lindenberger, also a pretty avid runner from what I understand. Dottie, thanks for being here. So real quick, you run with Karen quite a bit.
Yeah, I did run with Karen before she started training and back when we didn't have kids and when we were doing this during the shuttle days, I was running with her. We would meet once a week at a track with several other astronauts and do some interval training. And then we've had a chance to do a marathon together, some relay races, which are kind of fun because you drop a runner off and then you have to go run your leg and then you hand off to another one. So we've done that with the astronaut office too. And then the most recent time I had a chance to run with her was in Moscow. There was a race there, and it was a totally different experience. And so that was two summers ago, and we enjoyed cheering each other on and as we made these laps around a monument in Moscow.
Very, very cool. Now, you kind of like Karen. You're really into running. It's a big part of your life. You really advocate it. You know, why?
Well,
I'm one of those people. I can't run as hard as I try.
Right. People always say that my sport is like their workout for getting ready for their sport. But that's one of the reasons why I run, is that you can do it anywhere. I was just out at Wallops, and I was running there on the island with another astronaut, and it's really a sport that you can take anywhere, even into space. And it's important to do it in space. So I've enjoyed running on other continents and in other states, and it's something that just allows you to kind of get away from what you've been doing for the day, and just kind of a nice release, burn off some stress, or just think about something else for a while.
And running in space. I mean, you can't just... We have treadmills in space, but you can't just, turn it on and start running.
That's right. It's actually important to strap yourself down. That's going to add loading onto your body, and we use that loading to help our bones stay strong in space. And so the treadmill was designed to have both an automatic phase and then also a human propelled phase, and that's important as well, because as you are up in space longer, you want to have some of that experience of really pushing off and generating your own energy on the treadmill. So so they have the two different ways that you can work the treadmill, but you have to strap down, and that's what adds loading to the body and adds loading to the bones so that they'll stay strong. And it gives you that cardiovascular workout, because that's something that decreases is your endurance in space. So not only does bone density decrease, but so does endurance, and it is very important to have that treadmill.
And, aside from the treadmill, you told me you haven't had a chance to run in space, but
right.
You have worked out in space
yeah.
quite a bit before. I mean, what are some of the more common exercises also that the astronauts are doing while they're up in space?
Right. So I was on a shuttle mission, and we had an ergometer, which is basically like a bicycle.
Mm-hmm.
And you could, again, do it like just with different loads on it, and you would dial in the load that you needed. And tried to do this at least every other day while I was up there. Now, for space station astronauts, it is really important to work out every single day, and they have at least 2 hours of exercise where they're lifting on ARED, or they're actually doing resistance on the advanced resistive exercise device, and then they've also got either CVIS, which is a bicycle, and or the treadmill to run on. So a combination of all of that keeps them healthy for the duration of, upwards of 160 days in space. And so I really enjoyed using the bicycle. It was kind of fun to say, hey, I've biked halfway around the Earth, or, I spent, if you spend 90 minutes, you've done an orbit. And so I didn't quite make a full orbit, I don't think, but that's quite a long bicycle trip. But it was a good workout, and when I returned home, I did notice that my endurance had decreased a little bit in the time, but I felt that at least I had tried to maintain a little bit of it with the bicycle.
Okay. Now, you're into running, Karen, as we just saw, really into running. Any advice, anything that you could tell someone like me who just, can't get into it? Now, what really drives you to...
Well, some advice that I would give is to start slow. Don't just go out and say, I'm going to run a marathon tomorrow, because that's very
that
difficult.
Work.
That's not going to work. So you want to start out in chunks, and it's great to do it with other people. I think that's one of the reasons I love running, is that I've met many different people throughout my journey since I've been running since ninth grade, and just had the chance to talk with different people. So meet up with a friend, because you're definitely going to tag up with them. You don't want to leave them hanging out there. So, and then find something to run for. There's all these different types of races that have causes, and it feels good to run for someone else and to do it for the cause. So those three things might help you get out. I've been trying to give some of this advice to my own daughter, because she's just starting to do running in PE. And again, she's starting out with a small distance, and she'll continue to build up her endurance, and that's what people need to do. But it's a lifelong sport. It's one you have to listen to your body. You don't want to injure yourself, so you do have to listen to your body in that. But it's a great sport to take anywhere, even to space.
Very cool. Hopefully I can start getting into it now.
Yeah,
I'll go drag some of my friends off the couch or something and
sounds
see what
good.
We can do. All right, well, again, NASA astronaut Dottie Metcalf-Lindenberger, thanks so much for joining me today, giving a little bit of insight into why you and Karen love running, what someone like me can do, and also what they're doing in space. I really appreciate it.
Oh, it was a pleasure. Thank you.
Thanks.